Hello everyone, my name is Elizabeth Belugina and you are watching the daily stock market review by Tradimo. As you can see, S&P 500 got support ahead of 38.2% Fibonacci retracement level in the area of 27.22 and managed to reverse higher. Now the index is trading above the 200-day moving average at 27.73.50 and approaching important resistance in the area of 2800 and 100-day moving average, which is located at 2808. This is a resistance line which goes down from the highs of early May. And if the stock manages to get higher, the next level to watch will be located around 2840. U.S. stock market got help from the Federal Reserve. The central bank's chair, Jerome Powell, said that the regulator would act as appropriate to related to trade war risks, and it means that he left the door open for possible rate cut. Although he wasn't very outspoken about that, still he made that possible, and that took the stocks higher. In addition, there were some other positive news. Mexican president said that he expects a deal with the United States to be reached before the nation implements tariffs against Mexican imports, and that was positive for car makers and the stocks of chip manufacturers. And China's commerce ministry also said that differences should be resolved through dialogue, another positive thing. Resistance, however, looks substantial, and we expect the price to pause in the area of 2800 level as market players will await for further information. The decline below the 200-day moving average, 27.73, is needed to make the market once again negative. The situation is changeable, nothing is decided yet. Remember that it is probably too early to bet on the big reversal and the continuation of the overall uptrend in stocks. In the meantime, the stock of Facebook found some support in the area of 161.50, the 200-day moving average, and the 50% Fibonacci level, strong support which is guarding the further downside. And so did the stocks of Alphabet as well. Market analysts say that traders may have overreacted to the risk of federal probes into business practices of these companies related to antitrust investigation, and that it is difficult to foresee the future, but maybe the decline of Facebook was too steep here. So for now, as long as we stay above 160 for Facebook, there is the room for recovery towards 169 level. If we look at Amazon here, the Fibonacci levels are not at work that way, but still we see some recovery, and resistance will be located where the moving averages are, in the area of 17.53. All in all, there were some positive forecasts revisions regarding Facebook and Amazon, so that is helping the stocks of the companies as well. Banks performed well indeed too, and we can see the example of that on the stock chart of JP Morgan Chase. Of course, we can draw a resistance line here, and we see that the price is testing the moving average. So here we need an increase above 110 mark to become more bullish and target the level around 112 area. And finally, for today, Tiffany reported earnings, and the report was mixed. Earnings per share were above expectations, but revenue disappointed, and same-store sales declined by 5% more than expected. So the company blames currency headwinds and lower spending by foreign tourists. For now, we can see that the market is kind of uncertain about the further direction, and we can expect some consolidation between the levels of 96.85 on the upside and levels around 87 on the downside. This is all for today. Thank you for your attention and follow the market with Tradimo.